I left off a whole part of Gossip Chat, so just sit back and relax and listen to this and that chat, okay? Just listen, honey. Leave it be what it is. Hello, 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 everyone. Thank you for tuning in. I am Jay Lee. This is Jay Lee's Corner. This is a Gossip Chat. Who sends it? Anybody? Somebody? Nobody? The blogs, honey, the people, and just everybody, okay? I did record part of this last night, so, you know, you may see some cutting and pasting, so leave it be for one of the stories. That's fine, okay? But first things first, if you have not done so already, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel and become a whole Jaybird, tons, 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 and tons, and all that goodness and stuff. Let's get ready to do it, okay? Come on with me and inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. And just take a moment to relax, to relate, to release, and to center yourself, because a lot is going on in the world and people's lives, and we need to always remember to breathe, okay? You can also remember to like this video, to comment in the comment section. You can also hit the share button to share it on your social media. That always helps. Okay, you can follow me on IG and on Twitter at J_Lee_Corner. And all of that is also in the description box below, along with all other kind of information. Okay, go ahead down and look. Go take a peek. But let's get into these stories. Okay? Okay. And now for some this and that chat, which just means, you know, a little bit of this, a little bit of that in the blogs or whatever. You know, not no full stories, but a little bit of chit-chat, okay? So, comedian Chris Rock gets his first tattoo at 55 with his 16-year-old daughter. Oh, okay. Do we care? I don't think so. I mean, it's good, but you don't let it be. So, we do know, like, Tyler Perry shows on his studios is, you know, getting back to filming. They're filming The Oval. They're filming Sisters. He has basically had the cast staying on the grounds as each show shoots. So, like, one show will shoot their whole season and then leave. The second cast of people come and shoot their show and then leave. But Divine or DeVale was on, I think, either IG or Twitter, the little video. He said, you know, it's like we all live in the houses. There's two people per house. We all have our own room, our own bathroom. We get tested like every 4 days. You know, in between shooting, we still have the social distance and we can't still be like around each other. And I'm like, that's a good way to do it. That is showing that there are ways to get the show shot so people can still work but still be safe. Again, they're on set. We're all together. We know we're always being consistently tested, and we stay away from each other. He also brought up how during shooting they have smaller crews, the same way they usually would do if they're having like a sex scene or whatever. It's like minimal people on set. It's the same way. So I mean, that's smart. We know that also the Real Housewives of Atlanta has going to get back shooting. Candy brought up how they're still shooting now, or they will be shooting. And how each person is being consistently tested. Like every couple of days, they have to get a test to be sure that they're clean. Not clean, but still they're COVID free. Nia Long was told she looked too old to star on Charlie's Angels. And she said she thinks that was the way to say she's too black. That was when back when Lucy Liu, when Cameron Diaz and Drew Barrymore were doing it. I don't think she looked too old back then. She don't look too old now, truth be told. And I feel like they had Demi Moore was in the movie too, but she played an older angel. She didn't play like, oh, I'm an angel now. She played, I used to be an angel, but I'm not an angel anymore. But I feel like that was some bullshit. Okay. I know the new little round of Charlie's Angels does have a black girl in it, so I mean, I don't know why she was told that she looked too old for the part. But I'm like, what's worse, saying I look too old or saying I'm black? Girl, they're both bad to me. But I know I saw that movie she was in, Fatal Affair, Fatal, whatever. That's on, is it called Fatal Attraction? Honey Something is called, for her and Omar Epps. I didn't like it. I mean, it's the same thing as all the other movies we've always seen where, you know, is a couple and it's a crazy person who like one of the couples and they gotta kill him. How many more times can we as black people tell that exact same story? And the kicking part is all these movies usually have the same actors. Girl, bye. I cannot. Leave me be. Yeah. Former black Ellen worker says she suffered racism on set and employees slammed the alleged toxic work environment and that the be kind BS is all for show. Girl, I don't work this. I don't know, but I work at an office where I can tell that sometimes things do be some BS. So who knows? I mean, let them speak. Some people speak their truth and let them investigate and see what happens. Other than that, I don't know. Caitlyn Jenner wants to be Kanye West's running mate. I mean, two delusional people can definitely go sit down some damn where, but not up in the White House. We don't want you here. Not at all. Michelle Obama launches a relationship podcast. Oh. It's going to be on Spotify. And I don't have Spotify, but if you have Spotify, watch it, okay? Anderson .Paak joked that he drinks sperm with oat milk every night before bed, but later explained to CMOS. What was the point of that? For what? Who, what, when, where, why, and how was that a good idea to talk about? And as a joke, I'm like, people just stupid. Georgia Governor Brian Kemp sues Atlanta Mayor Keisha Lance Bottoms for requiring residents to wear a mask. That is the most dumbest shit I've ever heard. You're going to sue the mayor for telling people to wear a mask in the middle of a pandemic? Some people want us to die, okay? Anyway, next up, Monique lawsuit against Netflix can move forward. Girl, please let it. I need to move forward, and I need her to look. I need it to be over. Let it move forward. Let her tell her story. Give her some more money, and then she can go somewhere and do some comedy. Leave it be that, okay? Future accused of issuing dozens of subpoenas. Subpoenas to baby mama Eliza Rain's clients. Now, first of all, it's not her clients, okay? It's the people she worked for on, you know, like on IG, whatever. Like, you know, she may plug they stuff. She likes the ambassador of their stuff, whatever. So he's been sending them subpoenas to see how much money does she make and does she really need money from me. I feel like she do need money from you, but until she gets money from you, she gonna keep plugging these things on IG or whatever else. Future is taking, it's like they spending more money fussing and fighting that can be going towards the baby. It's just stupidity, okay? Rob Kardashian is going to return to Keeping Up with the Kardashians. At this point, he's the only one that we like. That may make me watch it. I mean, he probably won't, but I'm going to leave that be. Carly Red opening a restaurant in Atlanta in the middle of a pandemic. Okay, if she say so, let that be that. Colin Kaepernick's charity donates over $1.7 million to minority communities affected by COVID. Brava. Brava. Brandy says, me and Monica were put against each other. The fans and the media threw a wrench in that experience. Monica and Brandy were beefed out as teenagers, okay, and early in their 20s. They are now both down near 40. Move past that shit. Y'all are not aware of the reasons y'all were pitted against each other. It's y'all fault now that y'all are allowing it to continue. Truthfully, honestly, it is. I get it when y'all were younger. But now, there's no reason for y'all to not be able to come to a common ground. And that goes for both Monica and Brandy. Y'all can't keep blaming what happened in the past as a reason for y'all not being cool. Now, if Faith Evans and Lil' Kim can kick in and hang out and not be beefed out after they both was fucking big at the same time, y'all two can have a whole, you know, just not even a friendship, but be able to coexist without bringing that shit up. Damn it, man. Okay? Ugh. This gets on my nerve because I feel like every time, you know, anyone speaks of them, that's what comes up. You know, that was so long ago. Y'all need to let that go. Nia Long feels bad for Will and Jada because they've been extremely vulnerable. Will and Jada, to me, are the first couple that I can think of who literally went on camera, sat down, and admitted to having a separation and one of them having a relationship. Leave them people be. Ain't not none of the other couple that y'all have ever seen have came up and admitted, yes, some shit happened, okay? And after it happened, my wife was messing with somebody else, okay? We then got back together, and now we're cool. Do you know how many people in life who have marriages who one or both of them, you know, stepped out during a separation or not when they were together? Like, it happens. Like, leave them be. If you think grandmama or granddaddy did not cheat on each other and stayed together, you are a fool, okay? A plum D fool. Let them people be. They not the first, the last, or the only people to separate or cheat or whatever, okay? Beyonce and Jay-Z had a whole situation. They never came out and gave any detail. They sat down and did a whole interview about the shit. Let them be. Got me all mad. Okay, Kanye West still in the presidential race. We don't care because we don't believe that he need to be in it. He need to go sit this. Kim, get that man his mess. Get that man his mess. Sheree Whitfield said she's been out of it because she tested positive for COVID. We wish you a speedy recovery, okay? Cardi B reacts to criticism of Offset's Birkin bag gift for 2-year-old daughter Culture. When Cardi B said, if mamas fly and daddy's fly, then baby is going to be fly. I 100% agree. I think we have to sometimes recognize there's a difference between the parent not buying their child nothing and then getting them this expensive ass gift, but baby ain't got no damn toys, versus baby has all the toys they want. Okay, all the toys they want. I've seen Cardi B post videos of her shopping for toys for her kid. However, if mom and daddy on the carpet would fly ass shit, the baby should be too. And even though she's 2 and she don't understand a Birkin bag, when she's 16 and had that same Birkin bag, she'll be happy. Because at that point, it'll be vintage. A vintage Birkin bag. Okay, and who knows how much it'll be worth then. We can't be out here counting with pockets. They can afford that shit. I can't. They can. But I feel like we can't make it seem as if, oh, the baby didn't get no toys. They showed a whole birthday party with a whole bunch of toys. Sometime leave people be, okay? Leave them be. Michael Che, who we know was on Saturday Night Live, he has got an original sketch comedy series that will be coming on. Where's it gonna be at? It don't say. It says the entire project will feature 6 episodes produced by Universal TV, owned by NBC. But I don't know where. But he got a new show. That's good. That's great. That's great. Okay. We want people to be able to be creative. Okay. Also, Idris Elba has his Green Door Pictures production company inked a deal for a first look deal on Apple. Okay. It says that he will be able to produce both new series and features for Apple streaming platform, Apple TV Plus. Won't you do it? Okay. And then also, Colin Kaepernick, it said that he just inked an overall first look deal with Walt Disney Company, okay, for his Vision Media Company, and he will do tell scripted and unscripted stories that explore race, social injustice, and the quest for equality, or is it equity? I don't know. Maybe it will be equal. I don't know. But you know, that's great as well, because we just want people to be great. Okay, all up and through, Rihanna. They're starting a Fenty Skin care line, which I cannot wait. We all know that her skin always looks flawless and always looks amazing. So I can't wait to see. I got Fenty lipstick at all times. So we will say what happens. We will see what happens with that. Snoop Dogg apologizes to his wife, saying he's ashamed for messing with a lame bitch. You should be ashamed for messing with any bitch, lame or not. I think when you have a wife, you should not be out here, you know what I'm saying, putting your penis in other people or just entertaining other bitches. Don't do that. It's just stupid. Y'all been married too long for that to be a thing that you're doing, you know, in 2020. That's just don't. I heard, per the Daily Mail, that Justin Timberlake and his wife, Jessica Biel, has welcomed a second baby. They said that she had another baby boy secretly. Okay, not secretly, because, you know, it's their business, but they just didn't tell nobody about it. So supposedly, you know, earlier this week, they welcomed baby number 2. We will see if that's true or not. Tyra Banks inks a new deal as the new host of Dancing with the Stars, and she's also going to be an EP of the show. We know that Tom Bergeron and that lady with him, whose name I cannot remember right now, have left the show, and so she will be the new host. I don't watch that show. I haven't watched in a long time. I hope they're doing some kind of spin or better or update to it, because it's very boring. Okay, very boring. Portia Williams, Yandy Smith, and other people have been released from jail after being arrested, okay, for protesting for Breonna Taylor at the governor's home. I think it was Yandy, it was Tamika Mallory, it was Portia. I believe it was also like Trader Truth was also arrested. I believe there was a couple other people whose names escape me right now, which I don't like that it's escaping right now. But again, they all have since been released. And also, we know that they all were charged with a felony. They tried to charge them with a felony. It was like five different little petty-ass charges, but they tried to make one charge a felony. And I'm like, what? But they luckily dropped that one charge that would be a felony. The other ones are all like little misdemeanors or whatever. And I'm like, y'all gets on my damn nerve. People are still out here protesting for Breonna Taylor because the killers who are cops have still not been arrested, and the governor and the attorney general and all these people are like just not doing anything. And I am happy that we have people who have boots on the ground trying to get justice. Like, we may not see it on the news and on social media every day, and I don't talk about it too often because I don't want to bombard anybody with stuff that can make you be, it brings a heaviness to your soul, you know what I'm saying? But people are still out here actively protesting, okay? We are definitely in the middle of a pandemic of protests and of people trying to be equal and trying to get the wrong people arrested for the right reasons. Wait, no. Wrong people because they're wrong, but they're the right people, okay? So the wrong, bad people, trying to get them arrested is what I meant to say. But again, I mean, I think it was dumb to go and arrest protesters who were doing a peaceful protest, okay? But you will not arrest the cops who killed Breonna Taylor. It's just the most stupidest shit I can think of. But I'm happy that they all were out. I think they were only in jail for, you know, it was a day or less. But they were in jail overnight, you know what I'm saying? And I just think it's just kind of fucked up. We do know that a lot of people have passed away. Naya Rivera, who passed away, they did find her body in the river. I did not cover it because so many people had covered it. And again, some stuff I do post on my IG, so please be sure to follow me on IG. We also know that civil rights leader and activist and Congressman John Lewis passed away last night from pancreatic cancer. We know that Kelly Preston, who was John Travolta's wife, passed away from breast cancer. We also know that Nelson Mandela's daughter passed away as well. I cannot remember how she passed away, but I mean, it's been so much going on that I try to not consistently bombard y'all that information, because it can get real heavy. So I try to put, you know, a little light, a little love into that, okay? But again, that's really it, okay? We're gonna leave it be at that, okay? So thank you for tuning in. I am Jay Lee. This is Jay Lee's Corner. Make sure that you also have liked this video. Have you liked it? Hit the like button, okay? You can also comment in the comment section, hit the little share button, and also follow me on IG and on Twitter @J_Lee_Corner, okay? Until next time, people.